Hello, my name is José Emilio Labra. This is a joint work with Andra Wachmeister and Eric, who couldn't come here. And it was very nice that we have already a previous introduction to shapes and shape expressions. So what I was going to say is that RDF, we know which are the good things. It's flexible, extensible, and all these kind of things. We have a sparkle, but there are also several challenges that maybe it's not so easy to query when you don't know which are the properties of a sparkle endpoint. So you need some description behind those sparkle endpoints, and you don't know if two data models are compatible or not. And we have lots of success stories, but we also have a lot of work to do. My long-term project is to how to increase the quality and the usability of RDF data in general. To work on that, I wrote a book about validating RDF data. So the book is already published in HTML, and it's freely available also, the HTML version. And the introduction to shape expressions was already done by Thomas, so I can just skip that. Maybe the only thing that I could emphasize is that shape expressions have been adopted recently by Wikidata. So in the Wikidata project, we are going to have an ecosystem of shape expressions, which is an interesting idea. What I did in the last previous years is to write an RDF validator, an RDF playground system called RDF Shape. It is in GitHub, it is open source. It allows to do the common things that you want to do with RDF. You can visualize RDF data, you can query sparkle endpoints, you can also validate with sex and shackle, you can also convert between different formats, and you can also visualize shape expressions. So, I mean, I developed the tool for my students. I am a teacher at the university, so it can be done for teaching RDF. I think it works quite well. The common task that you usually do with RDF shape for validate is you have a sparkle endpoint. You can define a shape expression or a shackle schema. You can then select some nodes and then validate. So here the green nodes are the valid ones, and the red ones could be the invalid ones. Some other tasks that the users asked us to do is if they were able to select a set of nodes and from that set of nodes infer the common schema. So that was, for example, imagine that you have a sparkle endpoint where you have people, the data about people, and you want to infer which is the shape of that people. So you can also do that with the RDF shape. And they also asked us to visualize shape expressions, so you can also visualize using UML. So this is something that we already did. Some thoughts and goals is that it would be very interesting to have an ecosystem of shape expressions where you can reuse shape expressions from one sparkle endpoint to another sparkle endpoint. Also, what I think is that in general, domain experts, they are not geeks, they are not computer scientists, and they usually like some visualizations, and for example, UML, they usually, when I develop the UML visualization of shape expressions, they really like it, so, because they are people who they want to graphically draw the different shapes. So my goal is to develop better tools and to help RDF data models. And the task that I wanted to do here in the Bio Hackathon is to do some research integrating my tool, my RDF shape tool, with Cytoscape. So there is Cytoscape already, and to see if I can combine them together. Maybe there are some experts in Cytoscape here who can help. So what I started to do this summer, I started to refactor the RDF shape to separate completely the client, which now is going to be a React application, a React.js, from the server, which the server is still is implemented in Scala, and because I need to do a lot of things with Jena and all that. And then I want to, here in the Bio Hackathon, I would like to do some research about how to represent or how to visualize RDF data or the results of validation using Cytoscape. Of course, I am here, I am available, and I would really like to learn about the use cases and what you need about safe expressions or SACL. I think I am almost an expert on that, and maybe we could even organize a sex hackathon or whatever. Okay, that's it.